A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 27th April, on the front page you have Supreme Court gives RBI last chance to alter disclosure policy. So this is regarding the guidelines of the for RBI, which are contrary to the 2015 ruling of the Supreme Court on sharing information under RTI. So this is the context in which this ruling has come forth. So you can see here. So in RBI versus Jayanti Lal N. Misti case, the Supreme Court in 2015 had said there is no fiduciary relationship between the RBI and the financial institutions. So RBI has a statutory duty to uphold the interest of the public at large, the depositors in the country's economy and the banking sector. So RBI should act with transparency and not hide information that might embarrass the individual banks, and the RBI is duty bound to comply with the provisions of the RTI Act. So RBI was not giving the details under RTI Act regarding, you know, the companies or the entities which had huge defaults. So the case went to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court said that you have to give the information under RTI Act. You cannot say that we have a fiduciary relationship with the financial institution and we cannot give the details. So this, you can see, Supreme Court now has given the last opportunity to RBI to withdraw its November 2016 disclosure policy. So to the extent to which it stonewalls revelation of every other kind of information under RTI Act, including list of willful defaulters and annual inspection reports. So this is, you know, because the RBI also insisted on such powers, because if the details are put forth, then the company or the entity may suffer further deterioration too. So that is why it held that information and not give it under RTI Act. But Supreme Court says, no, you are not having any fiduciary relationship with the financial institution. You are a regulator. RBI is a regulator. You have to uphold the interests of public and the depositors and the economy. So that is why now RBI has been given the last chance to withdraw its November 2016 disclosure policy. Then here you have, let Bobde panel finish probe first, says ex-judge Patnaik. So we have seen ex-Supreme Court judge A.K. Patnaik has been appointed as the entity who would look into the larger conspiracy and the statements given by the junior advocate, the young advocate Baines. So he is going to investigate into that aspect, but he says that let Bobde panel, which is the in-house committee on inquiring in sexual harassment charges, let it finish its probe first. So he has been tasked with examining the larger plot against the CJI. So he says decision to wait seems to be his own decision, as there is no specific direction from the court. And the court, we saw yesterday also, they did not give any timeline or deadline to Justice A.K. Patnaik on this investigation. He should investigate and submit the report. This is officer dies in fire on INS Vikramaditya. So a Navy officer lost his life while controlling a fire that broke out on the aircraft carrier, an Indian naval ship Vikramaditya, INS Vikramaditya. So the fire had been brought under control, but a naval officer lost his life in the firefighting effort. Then below you have dreaming big and chasing their dreams. So this is regarding a political party, Bahujan Azad Party, which has been floated by over 50 IIT alumni. So they are contesting Lok Sabha elections in 5 states. They have been allotted the symbol slate. They say our party symbol signifies our motto, nurture the root first. On page 5 you have UK optimistic China will turn on Azhar. So this is a British diplomat who will be on a visit to India in May. So terror listing issue of listing Masood Azhar as a terrorist will figure during this visit. So UK seems to be optimistic that China will cooperate on this matter. So long China has been obstructing the initiative to declare Masood Azhar as a terrorist. Then this is PepsiCo goes easy as case turns a hot potato. So we have seen this case. PepsiCo had asked potato growers in Gujarat to pay fine, 4 Gujarati potato farmers to pay a fine of around 1 crore each. So this now has been settled. PepsiCo seems to have now gone easy. It has offered to settle the case with farmers. The farmers, calling for boycott and, such threats. We had seen this. PepsiCo's issue was that the potato variety which is used in its Lay's chips are being grown by farmers and being sold otherwise too. So farmers said we don't have any such obligation under any law that we cannot use the we cannot sow any potato variety as long as it is not patented. If it is patented, then there is another matter. Then this is High Court wants responsibility fixed in rationalists' murder probe. So this is regarding the murders of rationalists Govind Pansare, Narendra Dabolkar. So now Bombay High Court has directed the Chief Secretary, Home, as to actually file the details and fix the responsibility. So the investigation has been going on. CBI and senior officials of even CID, they have been meeting, and now they have been asked to fix responsibility in these murders. No arrests have taken place as such too. So the Bombay High Court wants one entity to be responsible, because CBI has also filed its report and an SIT, Special Investigation Team. You can see CBI senior officials and CID members. They have, that SIT has also been formed. So that is also filing its report. So all are signed by the Chief Secretary Home. So now Bombay High Court has directed him to say who is eventually responsible for the investigation. Fix responsibility. Then this is Manipur school burnt down for suspending 6 students. So this is a ghastly incident which has happened in Manipur. A missionary school here was burnt down 3 days after 6 of its students were suspended for a month for indiscipline. So this teachers here also have been provided security now. On the editorial page, the first editorial is parallel probes. So this is regarding the Justice Bobade panel also investigating, looking into the matter of sexual harassment, and also retired Justice A.K. Patnaik being appointed to look into the larger conspiracy. So according priority to inquiry into sexual harassment complaint is a welcome move, is what this editorial says, what we discussed on the front page today. And this is backstop option. So this is regarding Brexit. So backstop is the term related to Brexit, about Northern Ireland, how Northern Ireland and Ireland are connected, though Northern Ireland is part of United Kingdom, UK. So, and Ireland is a separate country, but they are on the same territory, same land. So Brexit modalities are putting pressure on the fragile peace in Northern Ireland. So backstop option in Brexit is a way in which Ireland and Northern Ireland can have convenient relationship with each other, like in trade, etc., while UK is exiting out of the economic union. So that is the backstop option. So that is discussed in that editorial. So backstop, actually it has been protested against, because Brexit is if it's backstop option, they're saying that this will be a backdoor entry for UK to be part of the economic union, and Brexit becoming meaningless. So it is hard Brexit which people are which the protesters in UK are demanding. Of course, there is another section which is demanding that Brexit should be cancelled, there should be another referendum too. But presently the scenario is that Brexit is being negotiated, and Theresa May, the Prime Minister of Britain, Theresa May, the arrangement which she gave contained the backstop option, but it was rejected by the entire agreement as such with EU was rejected by the parliamentarians. So now other modalities are being explored, how Brexit would take place, and backstop option is seeming to be difficult to achieve. So that's what it is talking about. Then this is lessons from a military encounter. So this says why New Delhi and Islamabad must keep lines of communication open at all times. So its cordial relations between the two nations are also important. We cannot be up in arms against each other. So this is regarding how war is not good for either of the two countries. Then competing for the best. So this is regarding India's ability to attract global faculty hinges on dramatic changes in its higher education sector. So this is that. Then on ground zero coverage, which is there on every Saturday, this is long wait for safety. So this is regarding a year after the launch of Safe Cities program, not much headway has been made in making cities safer for women. So So this is the report regarding how late dispersal of funds and election time restrictions have slowed down the whole process. So these are the cities under the Safe City program. You can see the list given here. So 5 of the 8 cities selected for the program count among the most unsafe metropolitan cities in India, according to National Crime Record Bureau data. So these are the 8 cities selected for Safe City program: Delhi, Mumbai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Chennai, Lucknow and Ahmedabad. And you can see crimes registered against women. So, and the ranking given here. Then on page 8 you have regarding the NDA leaders, including Prime Minister Narendra Modi, filing his nominations. And this is how his assets, because when you file your nominations you have to declare your assets too. So how his assets have grown over the years is shown here. During 2012 Gujarat Assembly election, the assets he declared were 1 crore 33 lakh rupees, total assets. Then in 2014 Lok Sabha elections, it was 1 crore 65 lakh rupees. And now during 2019 Lok Sabha elections, his total assets are 2 crore 51 lakh rupees approximately. So it says his assets have grown 88% since 2012 Gujarat Assembly elections. Then on international page you have anti-Muslim riots a possible trigger. So Sri Lankan officials now believe that communal tensions could have motivated the Easter terror attacks in Sri Lanka. The spate of anti-Muslim violence in Sri Lanka in recent years could have been the reason for more youth to turn radical and mobilize, according to top Sri Lankan military intelligence sources. So when one particular community is sidelined, it is seen that it is easy to get people to enter into such terror camps as such, because they also have their own grudges, they relate to it. And if the communities live in harmony, if there are no such religious divides, then of course the country remains safer too. So that is what Sri Lanka has seen here. Then this is BRI has entered a new era of transparency. So this is regarding Xi Jinping. It says China will work with others to write new global trade rules. So we have been seeing how the Belt and Road Initiative has been criticized for opening debt trap for its partners. So now the Chinese President Xi Jinping says that it has been revamped to counter this criticism too. It has become more transparent. China says that it will work with others to write new global trade rules. Then below you have China, Russia post threat to US. So this is FBI, Federal Bureau of Investigation of USA. The agency chief describes China as most significant intelligence collection threat. And this is Iran says prisoner swap offer only for US, not the UK. So a prisoner swap has been offered by Iranian foreign minister, and he says it is only for US and not involves Britain. So, and it does not concern Britons. So, there are US nationals who are in the custody of Iran. So, they will be swapped for Iranian nationals in US custody. So, this is an offer being made by Iran. Then, on business page you have government knack for dividends may impact oil marketing companies. So, Indian Oil Corporation, Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited. So, these buybacks possibly pressured by center to shore up its financials. So they have buybacks now, oil marketing companies. So these buybacks possibly pressured by center, so that they get financials which can be paid as dividends to the government. So this is what Fitch, a credit rating agency, says. On page 12 you have easier eligibility norms sought for FNO stocks, that is futures and options. So tightened criteria is a body blow to segment, the FNO segment, because huge number of stocks may fail to comply. So that's why eligibility norms should be eased is what is being sought for. So SEBI will look into the matter now. And then here you have share of technology patents on the rise in intellectual property filings. So intellectual property filings in India, it is seen that technology patents are on a rise, and artificial intelligence is said to be the fastest growing area. And this is Insurance Regulatory Development Authority and Development Authority of India forms panel to review micro insurance framework. So it will suggest, the panel would suggest ways to boost demand for insurance products too. So that is the regulatory body IRDAI which has formed this panel. Then on the last page you have 1 million species risk extinction due to humans. So this is draft UN report and the final document will be unveiled on May 6. But this is what it says, that a huge number of species are risking extinction due to humans. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs and to download the PDF, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.